2NURFM, a broadcast service of the University of Newcastle.
Joining us at the special day and the special time, John Fischetti, you've kind of thrown us all off our axis, mate. You're not normally here on this particular time, but we've all actually, before we get into what we're talking about, we've had an entire different discussion off the mic this morning, talking about movies. We could have just rolled that. That would have been
amazing movie discussion. Reviews.
We've actually ended up liking most of the same films that have come out in the last couple of weeks.
Yeah, they're challenging our assumptions of what happens and what was the root of the evil and the violence that's come in our society. Very compelling movies out there.
Yeah, Joker, Once Upon a Time, a couple of those. But there has been another review of how school syllabus is presented and some very interesting findings. And you're very quick to say that there are a lot of those findings are things that we've been sort of talking about here for the last couple of years.
I think if you went on YouTube and looked at the 2NUR collection, you'd see we've been sort of tipping this for a few years, which is really good. So this is the first thorough review of the New South Wales curriculum in 30 years. And the good news is what it's basically saying is maybe we go too wide in trying to cover too much and not deep enough in fewer things.
So a lot of the things that seem to get lost, because if you try and put everything in, I mean, there's only so many hours in a day, so much time in a school year, you can't fit everything in. And some of those core disciplines seems to have been not covered as well as they should.
Right. And the disadvantage is the current assessment process we use that leads to the HSC sort of is more about regurgitation of knowledge rather than display of actual learning. And that component isn't really built into this review, which may be its next step. But the challenge is now, what do we do to reduce the amount of stuff that gets covered in the syllabus?
Is that, or is that not going to be where the challenging discussions take place? Because everybody that has got their finger in that pie, like, well, we're teaching this, and over here we're teaching this. Hang on, my subjects, my discipline is very important. How are we going to decide what actually stays and what gets turfed out?
That's a really good point, and I think that's going to be the next period of discussion where the public can now interface and give feedback. A couple of worries. Even though this is exactly the right step, the assessment process has to change. That means the HSC over the next decade has to be revolutionized to be much more of the action verbs we talked about, the present, the exhibit, the perform, the demonstrate, the showcase, rather than the regurgitate, the write, the compare, contrast. Those are sort of at a lower level. We want to go to the upper level of actually action approaches. There are learning designs all around New South Wales, all around Australia. Big picture Australia be one of those that have already built in where you do something in the real world, like an internship, and you bring it back and you apply that by doing research and writing so it contextualizes. So we're going to want to look at some of those designs that are out there. The second is the deep knowledge that teachers need to teach the next level. You might have done at uni to this 2,000 or 3,000 level of courses. This means the 4,000, the 5,000 level to really get deeper so that you actually understand what you're teaching. So I think it means a new way to educate current teachers and get them the credit. And the third is, what are we going to do with all these new technologies? The smart tutors out there, we've spent a lot of time talking about, that can help young people with the basic sort of regurgitation of knowledge that comes in the practice form. We might not need teachers for that. We need them to go deeper. But some of those tools, they'll look a little more humanistic as we get them robots. But right now, they're out there on our phone apps that allow us to get a lot of knowledge so that kids can practice it wherever they are.
I guess it's all about getting students ready for it. We always talk about the jobs of the future, but they're really the jobs of like 10 minutes from now.
Right.
They're here. So, I mean, the fact that we've got the whole syllabus and curriculum not changing for three decades, that's pretty scary, because if you look at what the job market and where the employment options were 30 years ago, totally different landscape to last week.
And one of my worries is that the next decade to get this rolled out will be too late. So a student in kindergarten today might not even be taking advantage of this. And what does that mean for her or his future? And it also means that the skills of collaboration, problem solving, critical thinking, cultural awareness, global savvy, as those get built in, defining how they'll be assessed is going to take a while. They'll have to be tested, road tested, et cetera. And if that takes a generation, it'd be like you and me starting a startup today and not waiting and waiting for 10 years to know if we made a profit. We're going to need to speed this up. So I think while this is a great early salvo in the change process, we can't wait a decade to get to the other side of it.
All right. So you talk about that process needing to be kind of at hyper speed. It's a governmental thing. So we know that things and change move fairly slowly. How do those that have got to stay make in this try and sort of push that to that change to occur more quickly?
Well, I think our principal colleagues and teacher colleagues who will be listening or listening later will be able to see that a lot of what they have planted in their schools are beta versions of this already in place, and to scale those up. So that really is about engaging pedagogy. That's that fancy education word for the stuff we do with kids every day, is actually meaningful and relevant and not just sitting and listening. Because what I worry is some might say this is a chance to double down on fewer things, doing it the way we've done it. Just give me double the science the way we've taught it, and not really realize, no, this is doing it differently. So I think principals will be excited that this might legitimize what they've done in sort of their pilots around their schools, and to make those more school-wide sooner than later.
Hey, hopefully some of that message gets through, John, because keep in mind, most of us don't like or are not that comfortable with change, particularly if we've been doing
You're exactly right.
Time. All right, at least the discussion at that very broad level is happening in the world of education. Now, Professor of Education, John Fischetti, mate, as always, an enlightening chat. We'll go back to talking about movies for next time.
Thanks, Mark.
Right here at 2NURFM 103.7.